Okay, I'm so excited to welcome you to a brand new week on GOSPOCAST. We are continuing with Halfway In, dealing with unexpected, and it's a special dedication to second half of the year. God is calling us to finish the year strongly, no matter the unexpected we have seen on our way. Last week, we talked about take heed. Jesus said, take heed. I told you before, these things will happen. Take heed to yourself. Be careful. Guard your heart. And then we talked about the devil also wants to take advantage of the unexpected happening. He wants to put you under distress. He wants to steal your joy. He wants to disconnect you from the Lord. And he wants to do havoc, whatever thing that God has called you to do. We also talked about that God also wants you to take advantage of the unexpected to exercise your faith and to wrought miracles in times like this. GOSPOCAST continues right after this. Okay, let's go on today. Today, we're going to go a little bit deeper and we're going to try to classify the unexpected into three major categories. And the first one is the human factor unexpected. The second one is the nature factor unexpected. And the third one is the God factor unexpected. Now, today we'll be focusing, today and tomorrow we'll be focusing on the human aspect of the unexpected. And we're going to the Bible straight down to the book of Luke chapter 21 from verse 8. And what does this say? We're reading from the Amplified version of the Bible. And it said, this is Jesus speaking here. And it said, be on your guard and be careful that you are not led astray. For men will come in my name, appropriating themselves the name Messiah, which belongs to me, saying, I am he, and the time is at hand. Wow. Do not go after them. Now, mark that word. Do not go after them. Why that warning? We're going to look at it soon. Now, verse 9 of that said, and you will hear of wars and insurrection, disturbances, disorder, and confusion. Do not become alarmed and pain-stricken and terrified, for this thing must happen. Now, mark that word. Must happen. These things must take place first, but the end will not come immediately. Now, let's talk about this today. Today, we're talking about the human factor unexpected, because it's the one that we see every now and then. It's the one that we see almost every day. People claiming to be what they are not. People making promises and breaking it. We see it in our companies, in our workplace, in schools, by politicians, even by people we know, friends, people just disappointing and not keeping to what they said. Now, we go to the other side. Now, we hear of abominations, evil, insurrection, disturbances, disorder, confusion, and it's affecting other people. It's affecting your goals, your plan, whatever you expected or whatever you want to do. So why is this thing happening, and what does the Lord want us to do? How does Jesus want us to handle this? Now, first of all, you must be careful, because in Luke 21 verse 8, Jesus said, do not go after them. When you hear Jesus say, do not go after them, the thing that comes to mind is that whatever he said, do not go after, has the capacity to pull you out. Whenever Jesus said, don't do this, because there is a tendency, there is a capacity for you to be pulled. So anytime there is human factor unexpected, people creating things, generating havoc, it affects other people. You see of news of evil people doing, and people's hearts are failing them, and people are giving up on their goal, on their vision. Jesus said, do not move towards it. Don't let it pull you out. Don't. No. The first thing he said in Luke 21 verse 8 is, be on your guard and be careful that you're not led astray, that this thing don't pull you out. Now, look at the second part. Now, you say you hear of war, insurrection, disturbances, disorder, and confusion. I mean, it's just kind of a daily thing these days, you know. You hear of confusion, disorder, disturbances, and stuff like that. But Jesus said what? Now, look at what he said here, how to deal with this one. He said, do not become alarmed and pain-stricken and terrified, for these things must take place. Now, watch that word, must take place. What do you do when you know that something must happen and it happens? Oh, now that's where we are going to hit it today. You know these things must happen, and they happen, and yet you're still alarmed. You're still pain-stricken. You're terrified. But no, you should be excited, because he told me before, I knew that in the end days we will see all this thing. It should ginger my faith. It should make me strong. It should make me understand that he that said it had seen the whole time, and he knew what would happen, and he has taken care of it even before it happened by telling me before time that these things will happen. He said, don't be. It must happen. I told you before, so that you will be strong in faith and unmovable and focused on the Lord. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow.